Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here. I hope you're doing great in Jesus. Voice of the Martyrs. What a great ministry Voice of the Martyrs is. And they really give voice to the voiceless. And this was started by Richard Wurmbrand, who, if you've never read Tortured for Christ, I've read it multiple times. He's also got another great book about Marx and Satan that is absolutely awesome. Because he was persecuted under communism. And if you ever want to know why you don't want to live under communism, like, yeah, I can see why Christians don't. Look, they killed everybody, basically, except the most compliant of the compliant. If you had any iota or inkling of free thought, you were going to die. So anyhow, Voice of the Martyrs is a ministry he started. He has died, and it continues on. And people don't realize that Christianity is by far the most persecuted religion around the world. Somewhere between 90 and 100,000 Christians every year die for their faith. Now, that does not include in the 1.5 billion in China that they have multiplied thousands, maybe even into the millions of Christians in prisons and in semi-lockdown with their new social credit scoring system that they do, that if you're a Christian, you know, you basically can't travel, you can't own property, you can't do these type things. North Korea, we're praying that God opens that door, but horrible things there. Cuba, Venezuela, and then, besides that, when you get to the Muslim Crescent countries, you know, the 56 countries or whatever that extend from Nigeria to Myanmar and Indonesia, the horrific persecution that's there. And like it was said that Riyadh and Saudi Arabia and the Catholic Church just signed a thing for churches. But, you know, basically, the Filipinos, the others that are there, Ethiopians that are practicing Christians in Saudi Arabia, they kind of have to worship in private, or if they do have a church, they cannot witness to the population around them. And what doesn't get reported here in the States, so let's say in Nigeria, where there's tens of millions of Pentecostal Christians, you know, filled with the Holy Ghost, that the northern part of Nigeria is primarily Muslim, and they kill dozens of Christians on a regular basis, sometimes into the hundreds of Christians the Muslims kill there. And so it's just sad, and that's not a blanket condemnation of all Muslims. You know, I know some very good Muslims, you know, almost secular Muslims and all this, but many do get radicalized and tend to persecute. And in the best state, you know, they make it a dhimmi status, which, you know, taxation and all this. Pakistan can have horrific persecution of Christians as well, even though there's a mammoth Pentecostal revival in Pakistan. And, you know, Indonesia, Myanmar, there's huge revival there, but it comes many times with intense persecution. Vietnam, going back to communism, beats and imprisons many Christians. So these are people that the Voice of the Martyrs remind us of, and they give a free newsletter. You can get calendars, and I'm not sure their theological bent per se. I know Richard Wurmbrand, he went before Congress and showed the wounds of his, you know, several years imprisonment under Nicolae Ceaușescu in Romania. And so we need to remember this. And Paul said, you know, remember those that are bound as being bound with them. So I just want to make you aware of Voice of the Martyrs Ministries, and something that you, regardless of your theological persuasion, may want to be acquainted with. So God bless you. I'll talk with you later in Jesus' name.